Today in the news, AMD goes over 4,000 and Raja Koduri throws some shade. What's up guys, I'm Snows and this is your boot sequence. Let's get started with AMD. Looks like the Zen 2 architecture won't stop impressing us. Yuri Bubliy, the resident Ryzen memory guru from TechPoweUp, has been looking into the BIOS releases and found some technical info about Zen 2, and it's clear that AMD has been working hard on the memory controller. It was found that in the Zen 2 BIOS, the memory frequencies go all the way up to DDR4-5000. Now you might say, Snows, Ryzen 2000 can run at 4000 MHz. I've seen it before somewhere. Sure, but that is definitely on the upper limit and usually runs on a single channel. Does this mean that DDR4-5000 will be stable on Ryzen 3000 with dual channel? Not necessarily. I mean, we don't even have memory modules that go that fast in DDR4, so this is kind of a placeholder of some sort, but it does indicate an intent of high clocks on that memory side. On top of that, AMD is definitely taking some steps to avoid instability. You see, when you overclock RAM on a Ryzen system, the interconnect or Infinity Fabric also gets an OC, so 4000 MHz RAM on Ryzen will have a 4000 MHz Infinity Fabric. And that's where some shenanigans can take place in Zen and Zen Plus, like latency problems, stuttering, and overall instability. So AMD implemented a half divider mode to split the Infinity Fabric speed to half of what the DDR4 overclock is. It seems like a dumb move. Why would you want to slow down the CPU's interconnect to speed up the RAM? Well, I think that it might have some advantages, but they're definitely unknown to us right now. A lot of things have this sort of double-edged sword in computers. You can buy faster RAM, but sometimes the timing takes a huge hit and vice versa. You see what I mean? Anyways, knowing that AMD has been working hard on the memory controller does inspire confidence in Zen 2 and especially X570, since there is a high likelihood that those features will be exclusive to the new platform. With the first gen Zen, AMD really dropped the ball on memory compatibility. I mean, I personally tested 3 or 4 kits of memory before I settled on one because my kit that was in my Intel machine didn't work with Ryzen. So it's gonna be nice to see that improve. Moving on, we have Raja Koduri, who seemed to have thrown some shade at AMD. Going through the investor meeting, PC Games N found quite the interesting quote from the new blue team graphics architect. He said, in reference to AMD, that they have 2 architecture, no memory or interconnect strategy that he knows of, and the size of the developer ecosystem is tiny. In fact, without Intel's invaluable software contribution, they have no software ecosystem that's meaningful. Damn, that's harsh, but the thing is, Raja worked extensively on AMD's interconnect, the Infinity Fabric. He was even quoted as saying, "Infinity Fabric allows us to join different engines together on a die much easier than before. It also enables some really low latency and high bandwidth interconnects. This is important to tie together different IPs efficiently and quickly. It forms the basis of all of our future ASICs designs." I mean, he says interconnect right there. That slide that Intel showed is also quite interesting. The interconnect on Intel's side is layer 3 after the processing type and the memory, but AMD's current implementation also has IF tied to its cores and memory. Anyways, I thought that was a pretty shady move. Let's move on. Moving on, it looks like Nvidia is getting sued for patent infringement by a company called Xperia. Nvidia and Xperia have been in talks for several years about Nvidia licensing some patents, but they couldn't reach an agreement and Xperia decided to sue. This has to do with some semiconductor packaging and interconnect technology IPs. Oddly enough, this isn't the first time Xperia goes after giants. Both Broadcom and Samsung have been targeted in the past over 3 of the same patents, and they settled with Xperia for an undisclosed amount with a multi-year patent license. This kind of reminds me of that patent troll episode on Silicon Valley. If you haven't watched the show, please do yourself a favor and start it. Alright, so what did you guys think of today's stories? Do you think that AMD has their priorities straight? Is Xperia patent troll? Did Raja throw a little too much shade? Let me know in the comments, I'll be there all day responding to your questions. That concludes it for today, hopefully you've enjoyed. As usual, you can click right here to see the latest video, right here to subscribe to the channel, it would be greatly appreciated. Stay frosty, and I'll see you guys on the next one. By the way, I bit my tongue so hard, it's hard to pronounce some words. Take care.